Well, what a fantastic shoot at Park Lodge. Tough but fair, and not one eyesight test. This was the third FITASC England selection shoot. The Long brothers, Dave and Tom, did us proud. I heard nothing but praise for the shoot all weekend. The weather was great, targets were great, and the atmosphere was fantastic. But also I must take my hat off to head referee Bill Tatnell, who has brought the standard of refereeing to new heights. Smartly dressed, courteous, keen but fair, well done Bill, and thank you. Even my out-sparring partner Kev Joblin thoroughly enjoyed this one, saying it was the best FITASC he had shot for a number of years. And that's something coming from Kev. Morning everybody, we're at Park Lodge shooting ground for the English FITASC. We're just on the what's called the clay snooker, which is a poke shoot. And it's a fantastic way of getting a bit of practice in before you start. And it is very difficult. I've shot an 80, which is winning it at this moment in time, but good lads here today who can see them better than me, and they'll probably beat that anyway, so, but we'll keep his fingers crossed. They're all up in the air, they're all easy to see. There's no eyesight test, and I found it, very good to see. Very good targets to see. And testament to the Long brothers, Tom and David, always put a fantastic show on here. Get down to Park Lodge, you'll sure to enjoy it. Thank you. I remember this lad from the FITASC at,
Mount Farm,
it was, eh? That's a couple of years ago. He's grown a foot since then, and he's got a lot better. He's giving his dad a good thrashing now. You know, but his dad wasn't, he wasn't ever that good anyway, was he? Give him a stuffing on here. There's the first referee to give Dave Carrie a bollocking for swearing at FITASC. Can you remember?
Mm-hmm.
When somebody put that bloody rabbit on, and I pulled the stump up and threw it over the field.
That's it.
Yeah.
Then ran to the rave.
Ran to the rave, yeah. Everywhere, when I looked around, everywhere were all on the floor laughing their heads off.
Right. First man in, please. Mr. Carrie.
Oh. Best referees in FITASC. How long have you been at it now?
What, refereeing FITASC? Couple of years.
Yeah, a couple of years, and you say?
It's my favourite.
It's your favourite, is it? Because you used to do a lot of sporting refereeing.
I'm a sport trap.
You're a sport trap, yeah. Yeah. Well done anyway, buddy.
It's good to see you.
It's a pleasant day to be here and to be out, isn't it?
It's lovely. Yeah. The weather's been beautiful.
Yeah. I was just saying to squad today, it's been a fantastic shoot.
It has, yeah.
Absolute proper old FITASC. Barry, we remember these days.
Yeah.
So does Steve. We've had some. We've had. I thought these days are gone, but they're finally coming back.
They're all coming back.
Yeah, and I think that's to do with the refereeing standard today, because I think it slipped a little bit over the years.
It slipped in the last, I don't know, yeah, how many years. It went downhill quite a bit, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Now, we've got someone that's making them abide to the rules. That's what it's about. It's fair play to fair shooters.
And that's
Bill,
all I want to do.
Pull it there, mate. And I mean that sincerely, because you've set the standard. You started and you had a lot of stones thrown at you.
I did have a lot of stones.
A lot of stones thrown at you. I know you were walking around with a metal plate on your back for a long time. But I think, and I've said this to you recently, I think it's bringing the atmosphere back into FITASC as I knew it. What guided you into getting going again and putting the thumb screws on the shooters sort of
well,
thing.
The reason why I went into refereeing is because I lost a championship through someone cheating in the same squad in front of me, and I thought, I'm going to stop there.
Mm.
And that's what I done. I went out there purposely to stop anybody mounting their gun before and having the gun too high, moving before the target was actually in sight. Mm. And I lost that championship, you know, I'm only in it highlighted it, and I thought, I'm going to stop that, and that's what I went out to do.
But what I've noticed as well, Steve, is that every referee looks smart.
Yes. Well, I've got...
He's even smart. Everybody's got a uniform now.
Yeah, I've got the skeet vest. Everyone's getting the skeet vest, which makes us look the same as everybody else, a team. We're all the same.
But the thing is, it's got referee on the back, which stands out.
That's right.
Mm. When you used to go and shoot the European or whatever, you never had nothing on the back. Now you stand out and everyone sees it.
Brilliant, Bill. Thanks very much. Nice interview with that. Pleasure, Barry, always a pleasure speaking to you, mate.
Yeah, well done, Dave. Too, mate. Yeah.
Cheers, Steve. And ladies, thanks for keeping quiet.
No lipstick.
Lovely,
we didn't need any lipstick.
No. You can put it on if you want. We can have another hour talking about that, Steve, can't we?
We start again.
Yeah, we don't want to put anybody off FITASC.
No, not the old days.